Hey everybody, we're back here with the NewTek stage at South by Southwest. Mike Turpin is here. We're the new media team for Demo, IDG's launch event for new technology, and we're going to have a couple guests and give away a trip to Demo Spring.
That's a pretty good prize.
So it's really an honor to have the NewTek stage here. I want to thank NewTek and the whole gang for putting this together. Robert Scoble was just here earlier, and so we wanted to catch up, kind of talk about what happened down in LA. Mm-hmm. Lots of interesting things cooking. So Mike Turpin works with us, New Media Synergy, to help Demo spread the word for all the companies that are launching, work with the new media side, social media, and your company's based in, you're all over the West Coast.
Well, we're based in Santa Monica, yeah. Las Vegas, San Francisco, and New York. We're a social media marketing firm.
So what's been happening is Demo's been hosting innovation tours with Matt Marshall from VentureBeat and Neil Silverman. They've been flying all over the world to source the best companies hosting Demo innovation tours. So my last stop with that group was down in Silicon Beach,
yes.
Silicon Beach, which is the LA Santa Monica area. So what we're going to do is give you a scene report of what was going on in Silicon Beach. Then Demo was at Singapore, Asia. And now we're down here at South by Southwest.
Yeah, it's been fascinating the last couple of years, really since kind of Y Combinator came out, to see all the little areas that are now blossoming with their own incubators. In Silicon Beach alone, there's 7 incubators. And of course, we saw a number of great companies from Mike Jones' new company, Science, and there's 6 other incubators just in downtown Santa Monica.
I just saw Peter here on the TechZulu show. Shout out to the guys at TechZulu. They're using a TriCaster up there. I think Phillip's up there shooting right now from NewTek.
Yep.
So we started out with a demo innovation tour and had some cool companies come out. My friend was showcasing a product called Derivative that they use, it's called Touch Design, that they use to do Skrillex's show. Mm-hmm. And they do some really cool stuff for Coachella. A company called Teraduck came down with the Cube, which was basically a broadcasting studio that could like plug in with the NewTek, but it's all using LTE modems to get the data over the pipe.
Right.
You're down in Santa Monica. Give us kind of a play-by-play of what's happening there and what the growth story's been in the last 3 years.
Well, it's been remarkable, and we also have a big office in Las Vegas, and that's been remarkable just in the last year. So since the sale of Zappos, there have been all these new companies. One of them, Tracky, got funded just last week. They're here at the show. There's a number of other folks that Wall 360 from Vegas also just got funded. Yeah. They're at the show. In Santa Monica, I'd say there are now almost 500 startups in Santa Monica.
Wow.
And we've got a few of them here at the show. One of them is going to come up a little bit later to chat with us here. And Snap Cuts. And in Santa Monica, it's really, there's a lot of people who think that Santa Monica will be as important as Silicon Valley and New York in the next couple of years because of the combination of entertainment as well as technology. You've got everything from fairly hardcore tech companies that came down from San Jose area, like Sparklight, which is here, up to things that really depend on celebrities like Snap Cuts.
And the media savvy of that area, you took basically me to the Metal event, which is Media Entertainment Technology Alliance.
That's correct.
Great event. If you want to get tapped into the players there, I met producers, entrepreneurs, all kinds
And Ken Rutkowski, who runs Metal, also now has a 2-hour radio show on CBS that is syndicated, talking to a lot of those same leaders from Silicon Beach and
Silicon
beyond.
Beach.
Silicon Beach, Silicon Strip we now have in Vegas, so there's a lot of Silicon going around the individual areas. Austin, of course, has quite a tech community here, and
Austin Ventures, basically Matt Marshall was hosting interviews here at Austin Ventures, opening that door for demo potential candidates.
And they had a little startup tour of 50 different startups at the start of this show. Dallas has actually got quite a good tech community as well.
Yeah.
So it's definitely, you can see almost 20, 30 different cities starting to incubate startups. And then, of course, that's where Demo comes in to provide a national stage for all of them to meet the national media.
So Demo's background is, it's a really interesting story. It's been around for 20 years. Netscape, mm-hmm. Netscape Navigator launched at demo. What are some right. other companies that have launched at demo?
Oh boy, the Palm launched there.
Palm launched at demo, Salesforce.com, we had Parallels. Wii Video, a company I've
That's
heard.
Correct, that's correct.
He's coming up next.
Well, we in addition to having worked with you now for a couple of years with demo, we've been long supporters of demo. I've been telling clients of ours, both in social media service as well as PR that we provide for them, that if they want to be launching and get a lot of noise in a very short period of time, and their launches in the spring and the fall, you should think of demo first. And the ones that we've worked with there have been very happy. And you get about 70 companies that launch to about 100 media and maybe 100 investors. And we've had companies that have just taken off wildly from demo. We've had ones who got funded from demo, from relationships there. A company we launched there last year called Cloud9 IDE. Raised
Cloud9 IDE.
Yeah.
That is such a cool company. Cloud9 IDE has a cloud-based collaborative solution for programmers.
Correct.
It's awesome. It's basically like the DNA of the internet's being
software development in the cloud.
Yeah.
And they were able to go and meet Excel partners, and they got their funding from there.
So I want to talk about an event we just did with a demo alumni, and there's some secret stuff coming to demo. So in the last couple of years, I met the CEO of Groupon, interviewed him, the CEO of LinkedIn, the CEO of Twitter was there. So Fusion.io launched at demo a couple of years back. They went public, and then we hosted a party with them after they went public just in January. I don't know, maybe Steve Wozniak's going to be at demo. I don't know yet, but we had this great event.
He's certainly been there before.
Leonard Nimoy was there, so you'll be able to come down, and we're going to have a really good time at demo this year. There's lots of surprises coming up, and today we're going to be launching a contest to win a trip. We're going to go into three tips you can give to startups before they launch, so they launch successfully, and capture that energy after they launch.
Okay.
You ready?
Oh, I'm on the fly here. Three tips, right?
Yeah.
Okay, the first thing is to make sure months before your launch that you have a plan for launching.
Yeah.
You just don't all of a sudden one day talk to a reporter when you're not ready and that's your launch without you realizing it.
Yeah,
that's
yeah.
the first and most important tip.
Yeah.
So be able to know 3, 4, 5, 6 months in advance. That way you can. The second tip is to, if at all possible, try to launch at or near or just before an industry event where people can talk about you all at the same time. Obviously, demo happens twice a year. That's a great way of launching it. And other places are, things like CES and some of the larger things where you can tend to get lost in the noise, but at least there's so much noise that it still makes you very viral if you do it correctly. I mean, things like Highlight and Glancy launched here got thousands of stories.
Yeah.
And, at CES, We launched companies like Liquipel that got 300-400 stories within the week because it was at CES. Yeah. A week earlier, a week later, it would have still gotten attention. It's a waterproof phone, but timing is a lot. And then the third thing is to don't think of your launch as being the end of your marketing. So you need to look and say, how many ways can I sort of present a new factor about my company?
Yeah.
In many cases, if it's software, you can do concept launch, alpha, private beta, which can be very effective to get users at your time frame. If you think the platform will only support 100 users, just give out 100 beta codes and let someone like VentureBeat launch that for you and find your users working with your PR firm or your PR consultant or director in-house. And then just keep perpetually launching.
Yeah.
You have to stay relevant, stay new.
Okay, my three tips are this. Bring a bottle of wine. A good bottle of wine could close more deals than anything. I closed NASDAQ with a bottle of wine just to be able to be there and say, here you go.
Mm-hmm.
Number two is when we're doing social media for demo, we're doing real-time photography, and I like to see companies have a media package of content that bloggers or people who want to create stories can grab and use to create stories about them.
Mm-hmm.
And then think about a launch is basically the energy comes before event, then it rises up, and then it kind of streams down. You want to have all your content available, like photos, videos, and actually structure some tweets and things like that. So when you're on stage, you have stuff running. And then right after the event, think about what's the next lead up. Yep. So how do you capture that energy and carry it to a direct response? Yep. Like, are you, you want press, or do you have another a special event? Meet me backstage.
And it's a great opportunity to. It's a great opportunity to involve and create your community. For example, segue to WeVideo. WeVideo is a client of ours that we launched at Demo. And we suggested Demo. They really had wanted Demo in the first place. We were all in agreement with that. And they won Demo God.
Demo God, so that's a big award. It's basically, what is a Demo God?
It is in every category. There's five categories. So the 70 or 80 companies, you only get one Demo God per category. So they were the Demo God in their category, which I think was consumer.
Yeah.
And so they're very hot technology that's video editing in the cloud. So when you go, and I'll let them explain what they do.
Yeah.
But what we did to sort of further their launch was, upon the launch, we also started really working to build their community on Twitter and to have action being taken to sign up. And within 2 months of the launch, we had 200,000 people following them on Twitter, and 40% of them downloaded the product. So
that's critical. Putting all those pieces together is the art of the launch.
Yeah.
Okay, Mike Turpin, thanks so much. Let's have let's have you go off stage, and we'll have WeVideo come up next.
Okay.
All right.
How are you doing?
I'm great. How are you? Good to see you again, Tim.
So, introduce yourself.
Jostein Svensson, co-founder and CEO of WeVideo.
WeVideo. So, where were you? Did you just travel from Europe?
We moved the company over to Silicon Valley about a year ago.
Yeah,
So we came in April, and we were debating where should we launch. Should we launch in the summer? Then we decided the summer is a bit slow, and we looked to the fall, and then we saw the best place to then launch would be at Demo.
So it's really exciting, and what's really cool about Demo is we have an alumni network that's global. So Demo just did Demo Singapore, and it pulled together the whole Asian region, and now we're connected up with folks like Gavin Dai, from Zero to YPO China, which is like one of the founding venture networks for all of China. You came in, and you're connected up with the whole Northern European thing, government level, and now we have you today as part of the Demo alumni team. That's
absolutely
great.
It's wonderful to be here, and South by Southwest is such an amazing place to be. You know, I was just talking to one of the biggest publishers in the world, and I said it's amazing, you got everybody from hackers you know, to CEOs of big companies, they're all hanging out there and having a great time. Such a great melting pot to do business.
Yeah, we're up at the Startup America Partnership Lounge sponsored by Dell yesterday, and there's like literally billionaires to just scrappy up and comers like some guys that are going to come on here doing things in the collegiate space to spur entrepreneurship. So I want you to tell everybody out there what your experience leading up to Demo and launching a company was like, what you learned. And then, what's the story after that? What have you done to keep the energy and the ball rolling forward working with Mike at Social Radius to what's going on here at South By?
Well, we knew we had a great product, but nobody knew about us. So we decided, okay, how can we get the word out? How can we get people to learn about us? And so one of the first things we did was I called Mike, who I happen to know from many years back. He had attended some of my other launch parties on the French Riviera.
Goes back to Red Herring, yes.
Oh, really?
Yep.
And so since Mike is working a lot with tech companies, we thought he would be a great advisor for us to come as a European company now to try to go global. And we very quickly honed in on Demo as a great place to be. And it was very exciting because we knew the competition were going to be very tough. You know, it's an eye of a needle to get into Demo, to be allowed to present there. So just to be there and present is an achievement in itself. And we didn't expect to win the Demo God Award, because especially when we saw all of the other winners and we thought there was another winner, we were already in our category. So I wrote off that, no, we are not going to win Demo. And then suddenly they announced us as a winner, and I don't know if you remember, but I ran up on stage and we had a winner dance on stage.
Do the dance, you gotta do the dance. So it was
awesome.
You had fun with it, and that energy, just your smile, really, I think, adds a lot to it, just simple, subtle,
absolutely, everybody remember that, and the whole crowd just exploded. You know, Fiverr and Pete, people were just sharing on, and you know, when we were dancing on stage, so that was awesome.
So you're on stage, you're looking at the clock, the time is ticking. What what tips can you give to people when you're like the light is blinding you and you're sitting there? Or
You have to be really, really prepared, really, really rehearsed. Because if you're not, the moment you go up there, you'll forget everything.
Yeah, it's like during the headlights.
Yeah, so, you know, get good people to work with you on the preparations, preferably people who have done it before, and they can take you through all of the motions. It was very good for us because we were two presenters, so it meant that if one person had struggled a little bit, then the other person could shine. So,
Well, that's nice. You could balance and kind of like play off of each other.
Absolutely. So that was awesome. That really worked well.
Okay.
Because I think it's difficult for one person, unless you're a genius on stage, person to excite people for 6 minutes without any props, you know, it's hard. But it was really good fun to be there.
Okay, now let's go into, after demo, you've been coming to South by Southwest, you're sponsoring the film party, there's a bunch of cool stuff going on here.
Absolutely. I don't even know how many people came to our party, but it was more people than I could count. I don't know, what did we estimate, 1,000, 2,000 people?
Several thousand, yes.
Yeah, it was huge, fantastic. Really great fun, and we were launching there with other partners. For instance, we were working with Qatar Foundation for collaborative video editing between students in the Middle East and students in Chicago to create videos across borders. We are launching on our stand right now, Startup Idol. To give other startups an opportunity to go and present a pitch, edit a video pitch. And then it's a competition where people on the internet are voting for who their favorite pitchers are.
Yeah.
And it's going through a number of finals, just like American Idol.
Oh,
but
nice.
This is known for startups, and it's all running on
video.
We are not on any of the big networks, but we are on the internet. So so that's a great thing. And it's really awesome just to be here to talk to potential new customers. It's another thing we are looking at doing this afternoon. We just launched our new mobile app, where we actually can turn your mobile phone into a cloud-connected camera. So that means that you can go to a concert, and we are going to do a concert later today, where you can be shooting video, so you can be 5 people, 100 people, or 1,000 people at the concert shooting video, all uploading into a shared project. You can collaboratively edit and publish out even while the concert is going on. And I just asked our CTO, can you please increase the limit on number of people? So he just sent me an email now 5 minutes ago and said, okay, the limit today is 100,000 people can now can collaborate on shooting video at the concert. So we'll even be having people around the world to collaborating. So people in Buenos Aires, in Vienna, in Moscow.
Huge shows like Coachella have, lots of people are tuning into that, so that enables
New models. So the artist we are working with, Daria Musk, she'll be having a concert 5 o'clock in the Samsung lounge. She was completely unknown artist a year ago.
Yeah.
She said only her mother knew her songs.
Okay.
And now she has a million followers on the internet, a million fans on the internet. And so it's going to be really awesome to work with her and to show what you can do with our application and the user engagement and the collaborative production and editing of video.
Yeah.
It's a true paradigm shift that we are witnessing right now.
Yeah, no, it's hyper-converged what's going on. And I was just down in, my basically roadmap to come here was basically LA, then I was remotely operating Demo Asia, and then was in San Francisco hosting new media for the Site Conference, consumerization of IT and the enterprise. So the enterprise seeing all these consumer devices coming in that are being used for corporate types of situations, they're figuring out how to deal with this. And then it's a really disruptive space to see, like, to actually hear from the Ciscos of the world, the Microsofts of the world, of how people are dealing with the consumerization of technology and the enterprise. And then it was out there for the Apple iPad launch event. So all of these things are going on, and I didn't even get to go home. I took a plane right to here, throw clothes in a bag, and you get free shirts. So this is my only clean shirt.
Yeah. So and that also surprised with us about our company, because when we launched our company, we thought we were going after consumers, and we thought the majority of our users were going to be consumers. But we actually did some, we went out to our users when we had close to 200,000 of them, and we asked them, so who are you? What do you want to use our product for? And more than 70% of them said they actually want to use it for business. So then at New Year's, at Christmas, we were thinking about it. Okay, maybe we need to start selling to business also.
Interesting.
We changed to also target business. It didn't mean we gave up our consumer strategy, but it really told us that both consumers and businesses love us. Uh-huh. And so we also are about to announce a number of very big strategic partnerships with big corporate partners who will bring us out to millions of users. So you'll be seeing some very interesting growth and adoption in the market with our software this year.
It's the most explosive growth time I've seen since like 1993 to 1980, like, you know, in that time frame. But now everything's real.
Yeah.
You know, I've got a quad core.
Real revenue, real customers.
Yeah, with laser projectors.
Absolutely.
Well, thanks so much for your time. Tell everybody how to get a hold of you. The demo, really cool story is how we're keeping the alumni involved in creating a knowledge network. So how do people get a hold of you?
Absolutely. So our website, wevideo.com. Uh-huh. Just go there. You can register for free to start playing around with our service. You can email me. My first name is Jostein, and my email is very easy, jostein@wevideo.com.
Yeah, and then your booth is right here.
And our booth is here. Come and see us here. Go and check out the concert tonight, and maybe you can be among the up to 100,000 users. I'm sorry, the limit is 100,000.
That's not too shabby.
That can collaboratively produce video around the concert tonight.
That's awesome. Thanks so much for your time.
Awesome.
We'll see you. We'll see you.
Thank you.
I'm going to come by your booth next. So.
All right.
All right. Who do we have up next? Come on down.
Hang on a minute. I'm going to.
Okay.
So then we're just going to go. You can. You're done. Yeah.
Okay.
So give me your name again.
Daniel Wu, Majorna, M-E-J-O-R-N-A.
Daniel Wu, Majorna. This is Tim Rhea. We're here live coming up with our second guest. So what's been going on is I'm at South by Southwest, just came from the Bay Area for the site conference and working up there with an IDG company. And I'm looking for really cool entrepreneurs and inviting them up on the show today for a chance to win a trip to Demo Spring 2012. So Daniel Wu and I were up in the Startup America Lounge, and I used to do e-commerce. I built the world's largest golf e-commerce site when e-commerce was nascent, like 1998 to 2000, and you're doing a cool play in e-commerce and jewelry.
Sure. I'm the founder of Majorna. Majorna is a web-based jewelry design studio. Allows jewelry makers to create online and sell their own jewelry online.
Mm-hmm. So we're seeing this big trend where people like to customize products. E-commerce in the social media space is huge. When we're down at the Demo Innovation Tour with Peter and the gang from Science Inc., they're looking at all these kinds of new ideas in e-commerce. What's your spin on that whole?
Well, I think there's definitely a big opportunity to redefine what e-commerce is and how users experience the shopping experience. But more so, with a large growth of crowds, such as the crowds that like to curate, like to pin, for example.
So Pinterest. Pinterest has been blowing up lately in. It's just amazing.
Yeah, definitely. And I think that poses a lot of great opportunities. As far as for jewelry makers, that will help redefine being able to take an idea to market, really without the limitation of having to source physical supplies and to acquire costly materials before actually making the thing and realizing it may or may not work out.
So give me an example of my user experience to be. So it was my mom's birthday. My sister's birthday is coming up. Hi, Mom. Hi, Danielle.
Sure.
I want to make something custom, right? Or maybe I want to find a design that a friend's done or have some help. What's my experience?
Well, we provide jewelry makers a virtual design studio. And within the virtual design studio, there's a library of jewelry components.
Okay.
And we curate different type of components that the makers can use to
create beads,
pendants, spacers, different kinds of materials, kinds of shapes and forms, etc. And we provide a few different themes and commissions they can design to.
Just ignore me.
Okay. And when when they choose a theme or commission to design to, we give them the opportunity to submit the design to the to our Majorna site.
Oh, cool.
And we pick the best designs out there, and we manufacture and sell the design, and then we provide a cut of the profits to the designer, giving them some incentives.
That's cool.
To be able to participate.
So I'm an entrepreneur, so my mind starts spinning. Like, I've always liked those big football rings, right?
Right.
But if maybe I have my own ultimate team, and we, you know, I have five guys who want to knock out some big beefy rings, can we do that with that system?
Yeah, I think that would probably be more limited to maybe what kind of gem or whatever on it,
yeah,
or maybe
yeah.
what kind of imprint of whatever words you want it, etc. Yeah. We're really starting out with the 20 to 45 female demographic,
okay.
and trying to look at what kind of styles really appeal to that group.
Yeah, and that's a huge social media demographic online. They're super influential. Their words spread like wildfire.
Yes, yes. So I really think that Majorna will tap into that social graph of the users so they can be able to share out their creations with their friends. And that will help draw in more users to be able to iterate and create their own designs.
Cool. So what brings you down to South by Southwest?
I'm just really checking out all the startup related events. You know, I was in South by Southwest in 2001.
Oh, wow.
And very long time ago, and I kind of got out of the scene, and I just been hearing more and more, obviously just didn't make time, and I realized that this is the place to be.
It really is. Like, you go to these events and you never know who you're gonna meet.
Totally.
You know, turn around, it's like, oh wow, like
right.
Steve Blank was down here. I've got his book from Startup America.
I shook his hands.
Yeah. Oh, did you?
Yeah.
Cool.
Yeah.
Well, great. Tell us, everybody, how to get a hold of you and what you're looking for, like what you want.
Well, I'm looking for just people that will want to be part of this community. You can find me at Majorna on Twitter.
Okay. Hey, Daniel, thanks so much. I really look forward to get my Christmas presents set up next year on your system.
Thanks, Tim.
Yeah, it's really creative. Cheers.
Appreciate it.
So that was really good. Coming up next, we have some friends here that I met. Oh, Nathan here. Yeah. Yeah, I have a seat here.
How's it going? All right, let's do it.
Oh, good. So, Olark, I was posting up in a little side room, getting some air, getting some electricity, getting my charge on, and then we sat down, had a great conversation.
Yep, absolutely. We talked about Dell and Olark and what Olark does for you. We're a live chat product. We're the easiest way to integrate chat on your website.
Here's an interesting story that ties in with chat. In 1998, I was in the golf e-commerce business, and we couldn't give prices online for certain clubs like Callaway and things like that because of manufactured advertising prices. People print out. So I had to figure out how to give prices online when you couldn't. So we used chat, and literally we were doing like $60,000 a day in sales, and then it dropped down to like 10 when we couldn't give prices online. So we integrated that live communication really early, but it changed the game for real-time e-commerce.
Yeah, it's actually really interesting because we first started doing chat back when we ran a web hosting company in like the early 90s, probably around the same time you were getting started.
Okay.
And the thing is, we noticed in 2009 the technology was exactly the same as it was in the 90s, and we're like, wow, the entire market has changed. There's so many more businesses that are online now.
Yes,
and it's still the 1990s technology. Let's build something really easy so that we can bring it to the mass market and get all small businesses getting the same benefit that you got got back in the 90s when we were more tech savvy.
So it's a web service. I can just go in and basically cut and paste code, drop it on my site. Does it do intelligent call routing on the back end? Do you have the notion of agents and the deeper stack that is the, you know, that whole space?
Well, we do a lot, right? So when you're adding it, it's as simple as adding Google Analytics.
Okay.
You don't have to redesign your website or anything.
Yeah.
It's just as easy as pasting a little bit of code in the bottom of your site.
Uh-huh.
So like right now, the target audience would be like the smaller shops, you know, the 20 person companies, the 50 person companies. We do a little bit of that call routing, but the plan is right now to bring that really easy technology to a lot of the smaller e-commerce shops and then sort of work our way up.
People want to communicate now. I don't want to dig for an email address and wait for that. I mean, I'll go right to the Twitter account. I'll click a button to chat, and it's a smart tool to have, and you know, if you're trying to have real-time customer service and interaction.
Yeah, absolutely. We're seeing more and more of our customers not just using it for customer service, but using it for sales. And I think that's really where the market is going, right? Like, if you have a phone number on your website, you'll probably have live chat in the future. Because the idea, right, is people come to your website and they want them to contact you, right? You're selling a product. You want to build a relationship with those customers on your website.
Yeah.
And live chat is the easiest possible way of doing that, especially when you have an entire market growing up like SMSing all day, right?
Yeah. So no, everyone's just like this.
So it's just kind of like bring it up.
So why don't you lead up with that?
Sure. So like the other really good thing about our product is that it shows you, it lets you have a sense of who's on your website in real time.
So you can see them as they're going
Exactly,
across.
Yes. You just have this list of people, and it's like so-and-so is from Brazil. They're looking at your plans page, right?
Yeah,
like
yeah.
So-and-so is from San Francisco. They're using your product right now. Like, looks like they've been on this page. They're searching for something three times.
So I probably know
they're wanting to look for something. They can't find it. I can say, hey there, like, can I help you find something? I'm a real human being who's nice and friendly
it's
and stuff.
Human touch.
Yeah, exactly.
So, what as a startup, what are your issues right now on scaling, and what are your needs?
Well, this year has been absolutely crazy for us. It started out being like mostly just the founders and like some of the founding engineers. We've grown the team. We're now at 10 people. We're looking to hire two more. If there's anyone who wants to do DevOps or customer support for us. So that's basically like our challenge right now is just scaling the team, finding amazing people, which like we've done a great job of so far. I'm really excited to see that. And
talent's
like
tight,
keeping
right?
our servers running is another issue because our growth is just, so the servers, that's why we need a DevOps guy. So
do you have your stuff in the cloud? How does it?
We are, we're in Rackspace.
Oh, Rackspace. I have stuff in Rackspace, and Robert Scoble was just here from Rackspace. So we'll give Rackspace a little kicker there.
Yeah,
hey,
awesome.
What else? What tips can you provide to companies who are launching? So demos. Pulled together a bunch of resources. NewTek provided the stage here, so we like to give back. How can you give back?
To startups. Well, we love startups, so like we offer them a pretty good discount on our product because we know they're just getting started out. A lot of them, like we're bootstrapped for the most part. Yeah. We were in Y Combinator summer 09 and raised a little bit after that, but mostly it's just been all growth out of revenue. And so we definitely know how that goes. So if there's any startups who are like interested in using our product because like to connect with your customers, we definitely want to help you out. So that's one thing.
Yeah, Nathan, you guys are tapped into the valley. And I was just down in San Francisco. It's just nice to have connections. You come up to Seattle, you can stay at my loft, right?
Yeah.
And you go to Hawaii, you can come out and kick it at our nature retreat where you can unplug because you don't actually get cell phones. What are your connections in the valley, and what's the scene there like right now?
The valley has actually been really good for us because going through Y Combinator, and there was a recent Fast Company article that talked about the Y Combinator network. Most Y Combinator companies end up using us because they realize the value of talking to early customers, getting a lot of early feedback, and by having all these friends like the Hipmunk guys and the WePay guys and all these like new hot companies using us, it's helping us understand what those companies need and also having showing that our product is valuable to people as well.
Okay. Well, let's, I guess I have a mic and you need that one. Let's wrap up there. We got so many more guests who want to get on stage. So we will look forward to seeing you at back upstairs tonight and have a good time.
All right. Thank you.
So we go to olark.com.
Go to olark.com. You can install our web chat. It takes about 2 minutes. You can hook it up to your existing IM client and start talking to your customers now.
Is it mobile too?
Yeah. Absolutely. Awesome.
Absolutely.
You can see your customers right on your iPhone.
Well, hey, thanks for being a good sport and coming down. I kind of pulled you guys into this, and it was a really good time to give you some extra exposure. Yeah. So.
No, thanks, Tim. We really appreciate it.
And thank NewTek and this crew here. You guys, the NewTek team is so great. They launched at Demo a couple of years back, and that story's been around since the video toaster. This is like the first company that's been doing basically live video production, all that, so it's really cool.
Yep, props to NewTek. Thanks.
All right, next up.
Thank you, Tim.
Yeah, cheers. Thanks for your time. All right, next up, we got our guys. So entrepreneurship is all about, how you doing?
Good, how are you?
So we got Nick's.
Nick and Nick.
Nick and Nick. You guys mic'd up?
No, we're not.
Okay, here. So Nick and these guys I met just coming down the stairwell. And we're all like basically cracking and connecting up. And your guys' story is you're running startup networks in schools. Demos partnered up with StartX, which is a Stanford incubator. And it's just a good story to see how the pools of talent from the university systems up to launching at Demo are coming together. So give us the play-by-play or what your background is and what you guys have cooking.
Yeah, so my name's Nick Spiller.
How am I doing?
You're doing great. I'm an undergraduate at the University of Texas, and I basically last week headed up UT Entrepreneurship Week with a group of 12 student entrepreneur leaders, and they basically brought together 15 different institutions, organizations, departments to host a week-long series of events focused on inspiring, empowering, promoting student entrepreneurs. Everything went great. We're looking forward to moving forward, sustaining and growing our community and our network of student entrepreneurs by hosting strategic events, connecting our entrepreneurs to the resources they need, like co-founders, mentors, education, funding, and it's pretty exciting, and I think good things are on the way. And this is Nick.
So Nick and you guys are helping with my tripod, and then we had a good time.
Yeah, we're doing a little bit of everything. So my name's Nick Tittman. I'm an undergraduate at IU. I actually haven't hosted an entrepreneurship week like Nick Spiller over here, but it's coming. It's on the way. We're on the works. I'm actually helping a group called Verge Indy out of Indianapolis. We're moving a chapter down to Bloomington. It's a startup community. It grew from zero to they hit 1,500 members last week, and they just started a chapter up in Lafayette, and we're moving one down to Bloomington here hopefully next week. And we're just trying to grow the entrepreneurship community up in Indiana because it wasn't booming, and now it is. Now we got some grassroots going, and things are really going well. We got some great companies coming out of Indianapolis.
It seems like it's just from when I went to school, I thought entrepreneurship was bad. Like you had to go work for a company. Yeah. It was like,
right.
But. The new mindset is there's actually a lot of support now, and you can do it.
Yeah, so I started a business back in high school. So my dad's an entrepreneur. My grandpa's an entrepreneur. It runs in my blood. I went to school for entrepreneurship. I knew it was the only thing I ever wanted to do with my life. So I never really saw a big company as an option. So, I mean, that's kind of my background. And it's not traditional, but we're trying to make it a path that more students can choose. And so it is something that people can think that I want to be an entrepreneur, not I have to go work at a company.
So what are your guys' three wishes? I want you to talk to the audience out there, to the world, and say, hey, this is what we need, and we need it now.
So what I found just if we look at University of Texas as a microcosm of the whole student entrepreneurship movement across the nation is that there's no rhyme or reason of where the student entrepreneurs are coming from. They're coming out of their flowers, coming out of the woodworks, basically. And we know there are more of you out there. So basically, the one thing I want is if you're out there watching and you're at particularly a public research university, and you're an entrepreneur and you don't know where to go, call me right now. After I walk off stage, my number is 810-814-0727. Let's talk, let's get it going, let's build, let's create a community that supports and looks up to student entrepreneurs.
Did you practice that? That was pretty good.
Awesome. Yeah, he's been trying to get the word out to everyone. But yeah, if you're an entrepreneur out there, you need help, you're looking for funding, you're looking for mentors, you need education, you just need someone to talk to because you don't know how, hit either one of us up on Twitter or like you said, his phone number. My phone number is 260-438-8708. We don't care. We'll talk to anyone. We're trying to help the community. We're trying to grow the entrepreneurship crowd. We want kids to really think that this is an option because it is. It's not some mystic black hole anymore. Yeah. There's a paved path, and there's people that want to help you do it.
Websites and how do people connect up?
So you can check me out at nicktippmann.com, nicktippmann.com, or on Twitter at ntippmann.com, or ntippmann, ntippmann.
The best way if you want to follow what we're doing here at the University of Texas is my blog. I basically follow the student entrepreneurship scene and how that
the ecosystem that we have at the University of Texas at Austin. The URL is youthinktanknick.com, the letter U, thinktanknick.com. And you can also follow me on Twitter at nick_spiller.com.
That's not good. .com. So you want a trip to demo. We're going to bring you guys down there.
Yeah, I'm super excited. Super excited. Thank you, Tim.
So we'll have you guys down for that. So now we're going to go into our next section, which is basically 2-minute pitches with some cool companies that I found here that
awesome.
Are going to talk about
awesome.
What they're doing. So
well, thank you so much, Tim. It's really been great.
Yeah, it was awesome.
Thank you.
Yeah.
Do you want it both on there?
Yeah.
Already
my mic's on this side. All right.
That was a good talk on entrepreneurship.
Yeah, thank you.
Non-traditional, cool.
I think you're good. What's the?
Pam. Here, Pam, we're live.
So, hey, everybody, we're still live. We're getting the next guest up. Hey, Ola, how are you?
Hi, good, how are you?
So, where did I see you last? I saw you in Seattle.
Demo.
And then I saw you at Demo, and then we're at the Steve Woz party down in San Francisco. And you guys are doing what?
We are Spinner, and our core business is fetching and delivering fast-changing web content.
Okay.
So that is blogs, social media, news. And we provide data to analytics companies, marketing analytics, and media monitoring companies. So we're the largest crawler, basically, for that space.
Yeah, they have a mic here. What's really cool is you're able to see what goes on in the social media sphere more than most companies do because you're dealing with such vast data.
Yes. So we definitely see what's going on and across the board. We're making progress in building our own social web intelligence tool, which is my head is preoccupied. What is the fastest and the simplest way of understanding social web and monitoring social space? So this is what I'm working on.
That's cool. So we have Snapcuts here. Yeah, and you're working with Mike Turpin?
Yes.
Yeah, cool. Yes. Tell us about Snapcuts.
Okay, it's called Snapcuts. It's a video social messaging in which we provide clips. The user mashes them together, adds text, and sends.
We'll give you a mic here.
We're a video social messaging. We are a video social messaging. And we provide clips. Users mash them together. We add text and send them. And the thing that's unusual about it, that's a little different, is we provide the clips. I was an editor for 30 years of music videos. And find the clips and edit them such that when you put them together, they all look good, so everyone looks good. The big idea is we're an advertising platform.
Okay.
We white label to other, we're doing some major bands and everything, films, hotels, so that they put their clips on, users can mash them up and send them from local plumbers to MGM Resorts to American Express.
That's exciting,
and,
that's a pretty big
can vision. I show it to you real quick? They said.
All right.
Here.
Just like really quick, because we got another.
Okay, really quick. We got to do this really quick. Okay, you play clips. Does anyone get it? Okay. Okay, you add them. I'm doing this left-handed, by the way. And you can mix them around. They always play together. See, they go one right after another.
Oh, they just.
You make, yeah. And then you add a and then you add a text message. I know. He's gonna go. I'm gonna show you right away. There's a text message, and then you share. Email, you put on your email.
So video is the fastest growing communication medium of all time right now, and this whole data story is really interesting because you got videos and tweets and all of that flying around.
And the different thing about this is it's not an Evite, it's not a film. It is a message. We have it organized. For when you want to say hi, you're mad at your girlfriend, you're running late.
Is this like Storify for video? Storify
video? Yes, except it's we're building an aesthetic of the times of boom, boom, boom.
Yeah.
You can save them. We make some for you. You can customize them. And anything from a new movie premiere or a new TV show, the fight, we're doing the big fight.
Oh, really?
So you actually predict the outcome.
Oh,
on, you know, on like round two, Mayweather gets knocked out or something.
That's cool. That's cool.
So,
what have you seen here at South by Southwest that was really hot, interesting?
I like Wii Video.
Yeah, those guys are cool.
As an editor.
For us, everything is interesting. Social web changes so much, evolving.
Yeah.
So for us, it's been really great to connect with our customers that we don't see. They're worldwide customers, so their majority are here.
Yeah.
So it's been really interesting.
So there will be a demo in April, and you can catch me on the fourth floor upstairs at the Hilton for the rest of the day at Startup America Lounge, sponsored by Dell. Thank you. My name's Tim Reha.